Cambridge Cognition is a healthcare technology company. They have developed and they're commercializing a computer-based cognitive assessment tests. Basically, those are tests meant to assess a variety of cognitive functions, such as memory, for instance, which are usually monitored in patients with neurological diseases ranging from dementia to Parkinson's to depression. So Cambridge Cognition's product portfolio is made of software designed cognitive tests. In the industry, they're still widely used pen and paper based tests. What makes software based assessments much better compared to the paper ones is twofold. Basically, one is the fact that it's much easier to analyze and dig deeper into the data if they are in a digital format, obviously. And the second one is that the software can be integrated in other technology products, such as mobile applications and this kind of softwares, which is clearly impossible with a pen and paper based test. So traditionally, Cambridge Cognition has provided their clients, which are academic institutions and larger pharmaceuticals and biotech companies running clinical trials, with their software on a project-by-project basis. And this has led to historically a lumpy revenue stream, precisely because these contracts were related to specific clinical trials or academic research projects. Right now, they're venturing into new areas in order to improve these critical aspects of their business. In particular, they're working with their pharmaceutical clients to integrate Cambridge Cognition softwares into their internal research and development process. This way, they could progressively produce recurrent revenues for Cambridge Cognition itself. And the second aspect is their expansion into the wearable devices market. So the integration of their software with other technological applications, which will be run through smartphones or tablets. So the company has recently announced a collaboration with Takeda, a multinational pharmaceutical company, whereby they will run a clinical trial in depression to see how monitoring patients' mood and patients' cognitive functions through wearable devices improves the outcome and the compliance of the patients in the depression setting, which is a very big and large therapeutic area, given the number of people affected by this type of mental illness. And also because of the opportunities offered by the development of software cognition tests, we believe they're likely to develop new products in terms, for example, of voice recognition on facial recognition, which will attract the interest not only from the traditional world of pharmaceuticals, but also from the world of the technology companies such as the Googles of this world.